I upgraded the Lego Retro radio set with a Raspberry Pi to make it an actual functional radio. Let me show you how I did it.
Lego have made this very cool retro radio, but there's just one problem. It doesn't actually play radio. But I think I've got a plan to fix that. So, step one, we've got to build the Lego.
So we start to get a little spinner going on here. Oh, I've never seen a piece like this before. And it moves along there, so when I spin this, isn't that satisfying? So it can move this dial, and then it stops at the end. Ah, there's that that stops it, that's super cool. I think this just goes on here, like this. Okay. Nice. There's a cog here. Definitely going to connect to something later.
Very, very cool.
I'm going to do something for the on-off button, I think. Yeah, that's what creates that satisfying click, I think, because it rubs against that rubber thing. This little button here, I think this goes that way. And then this clips on the top, nice little top for it. Oh, isn't that beautiful, that button? Oh yeah, it goes into this hole here. And then I think we put something on the bottom just to hold it in place. Another one of these cogs. Wow! Okay, there's a... Oh, that feels so nice to move! I've got these cogs here, which I guess have to go into those holes there. And you kind of... you push them out first and put them in place. And then you push these in. Oh my gosh, it's so satisfying! I'm gonna do something like this is gonna... Oh, this is gonna turn this. Right, this is so clever. So now I've made this little pin. I think this is going to go on here. Yes! Move the dial, this moves the pin. So step three is complete. We got the nice on-off button. We've got this dial that moves. This is so good. I'm not quite sure exactly what's going on here, but there is this thing that turns around. There is also something under here, which when this turns, it pops out. Can you see it? This little dot here. And I think that's going to come and click the sound brick that's probably going to go in here. I had to go back a few steps because I made a mistake with this orange piece here. So when this is off, you see it disengages that grey bit there, which means that this just turns the dial. Okay. And when it sets it on, it will engage this little cog here, which engages these ones down here. And that's what will turn this bit here. When I turn this, it's very, very clever. Look at that, isn't that lovely? Okay, on, off, yes. Yes, it's still working. On. And then this moves as well. Awesome.
The next step is to build the front grille, which actually clips in with these little holes in the side. It's very clever. And with that grille comes the mobile phone attachment. When you put the phone inside, there's like, well, let me show you this. This back bit comes off, you see, and then the grille will be on here. And then there'll be an attachment to put your mobile phone in. I'm not sure if I want to keep that. I might end up taking that away. But let's build the grill and the attachment and then see what we want to do with it.
Okay, I've just got to show how clever this is. So I've built this mechanism at the back, which slides up and down, and it's got a rubber band to keep it from going too far. So this is what's going to hold your phone in. Also, I love all the grills on the front. It's so nice. The time has come to put the front on, so it should just drop into here. Yes. And then these pins are going to hold it in place. Oh, wow, it works so well. Yes. Nice. And then, like I was saying, you can take off the back. There, you might be able to see now how the mechanism works. I have to say, I really appreciate that these elements are printed. I hate stickers. Oh, look at that. Okay, that is so nice. Just look how this antenna clips together. There's lots of small pieces like this, and it's really looking good. And it just clips in up here. And then it folds down and fits in there. Oh, isn't that nice? I've built the handle, which is really nice. You can actually hold it by the handle. Amazing. And now the most exciting part comes. This is the little sound brick. And when you press it here,
okay, caller, guess that sound.
It makes some noises, okay?
It's good for the astronaut and good for your family. Ham salad.
Okay, so this one we're going to have to put into the radio. This goes in there. Okay, now we'll put the back on and we'll see if it works. So, you're going to turn on the radio and then you dial it. Amazing, it works!
On a submarine.
So step one is complete. I've built the Lego radio and it is working as it should. Now, to make it into a real radio, there is something it's meant to do, is you're meant to be able to put your phone in the back like this. Okay, so then you can play music through your phone and it's quite convincing. But I don't want to put my phone into the radio all the time. So I have got myself a Raspberry Pi and I've installed Volumio on it. So when you turn it on, I've set it to start playing radio automatically. And then I got one of these little, speaker, which can plug in here. So it should start playing some radio any moment now. Yes, indeed, it is playing some music. And the cool thing is I can control it from my phone, so I can control the volume. Wait, let's do that. So volume can go down or up. And I've got some favourite radio stations. Yeah, so I can switch to a different radio station. And it controls the Raspberry Pi. So this is cool, right? So the only thing left to do is to put this inside the radio. And I think it might actually go quite well if I put it down like this. Yes, I've managed to fit it in like this, and I didn't even have to take this bit out, which I thought I might have to. It actually holds it in really nicely. Of course, the cable has to come from here out of the radio. I think the easiest thing would be to remove the sound brick, and then there'll be a hole for the cable to come out. If we can check that this will go back on. Yeah, that's going to work quite well. And the speaker is actually just behind this grill here, which is perfect. Okay, so I'll switch the channel. Wow, it's nice. And I'll put up the volume. Oh, isn't that beautiful? I'm just going to put this in here, but to close the hole a little bit. There we go, that's nice. So I did it. I made a working Lego radio. I'm so pleased with it. Now, of course, the stretch target would be to make the on-off switch actually do something, because I guess it just needs some electronics to connect a circuit to the Raspberry Pi. And ideally, to make this tuner actually change channels, switch between my favourite channels, that would be so cool. So if anyone has any ideas how I could do that, please do leave a comment and give me some ideas. But for now, I am really, really happy with this. And just for fun, I'm going to pretend I'm switching it off. Here we go. Yes! Thank you very much for following along. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed building it. See you soon.
See you again soon. I just want to say I've put this radio on my desk and it's working and I really, really love it. I'm going to listen to this all the time now.